Hi, this is Almir. We're stationed with Cape Town Emergency Medicine, and today I'm being assisted by Mohammed Al-Sheri, also of Cape Town Emergency Medicine. This video forms part of our video series on CPR and resuscitation, and in this video we will show you how to integrate use of the AED into the BLS sequence. The BLS sequence starts with the three H's, hazards, hello, and help. For hazards, I don universal precautions, and as I approach my patient, I make sure the environment is safe for myself, the patient, and my assistants. I then check responsiveness. Hello there, sir. How are you doing? If there is no response, I assume cardiac arrest and activate my help system. Muhammad, go get us some help. Bring me the resus trolley and the AED as soon as you can. I then proceed to the C of CAV, checking for a pulse for no more than 10 seconds. If there is no pulse, I immediately start CPR with chest compressions. 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13. I'm going to perform 30 compressions to 2 breaths. 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2. AED, alright. While my assistant is preparing the AED for use, I continue CPR as I would even if the AED was not here.
Apply pads to patient's bare chest. Plug in pads connector next to flashing light. Apply pads. Plug in connector. Analyzing heart rhythm. Do not touch the patient. Shock advised. Charging. Stay clear of patient. Deliver shock now. Red shock delivered. Pause. Start CPR.
The pulse check and delivery of a shock is a good time to switch rescuers. This allows your rescuers to last longer as they don't tire as quickly. After a further 5 cycles or 2 minutes of good quality CPR, you will repeat the process by using the AED again and switching rescuers. And that's it. Integration of use of the AED into the BLS sequence for adults.